Myself Nagma. Today 9th standard we are going to deal with lesson number 2, that is Mauritius, written by R.K. Lakshman. So this lesson has got some main points which have listed in this board summary. I have divided this lesson in three parts. In that three parts, we can see that location. The lesson consists of location of the island, that is in an island. This Mauritius island locates in Indian Ocean. Then, inhabitants of the island: Africans, Indians, Chinese, Dutch, Persians, Arab, French, and English. And what is the occupation they carry in this island? Physical feature of the island. What and all physical feature Mauritius has, the lesson deals with it. Then, in that, pyramidical shape mountains, short gnarled trees. There are no wild animals as such, but the dodo bird has originated in Mauritius. Then there is beautiful coral reef in around the island, and weather and storms, which and all storms affect Mauritius. Then building of those of the island, economy, administration of Mauritius. We'll begin today. In this video I'm going to deal with totally there are 20 paras in this lesson. In this video I will explain 10 paras. Till 10 paras I will explain, and remaining 10 paras I will explain in my next video. So to begin with, the location of where is Mauritius and how the author visited Mauritius, what and all is his experience he has explained in this. This lesson is basically about the location and his interest. All these things he has listed out. We'll begin. The World Atlas, para number 1. Look into the book. The World Atlas I have with me has many little dots and specks, which have really nothing to do with the world of geography. So it means the World Atlas he had, R.K. Lakshman had, was a old one which was destroyed by the cockroaches and ants. It is an old one, and time, the weather and generation of cockroaches have put them there. So it was with some difficulty that I was able to locate Mauritius in the vastness in the Indian Ocean. It is a tiny speck of an island situated below the equator on the 20th parallel, some 4,500 kilometers southwest of Mumbai. So Mauritius is a tiny island located in Indian Ocean, which is situated in southwest, almost 4,500 kilometers away from southwest Mumbai. Second para speaks about our aircraft, how he traveled to Mauritius. Our aircraft is bearing us towards it. Through the occasional gloss in the clouds, I glimpse the ocean spread like a bluish gray steel sheet. There are acres and acres of cloud below me, having all sorts of funny shapes in an old abstract way. Curiously, they resemble figures in an ancient legends of China, Rome, Greece, India, and what have you. So while he was traveling by aeroplane, he just sees and he tells there are acres of acres clouds below the aeroplane. So the aeroplane plane is flying high above the clouds, and he can see, he can figure out the clouds into some old shapes, funny shapes of Greece and Asian, Chinese, Rome and Greece figures. So you can predict your own figures from the clouds. Third para. I cannot help drawing a comparison, albeit ridiculous and rather far-fetched, between my vague observation at 10,000 meters, watching the clouds, and what I learn of Mauritius later. I learn of Mauritius later. This tiny island has an astonishingly similar variety, strange juxtapositions, incongruities, and mixtures of race and language. So this is, after landing, he can observe some strange things about Mauritius, and some there are variety and similarity, and there are just oppositions. Just opposition means side by side, congruities, and admixtures of race. Races are mixed. Races are there in Mauritius. Mixed races means it of people from different part. Para number 4. Here, Africans and Chinese, Biharis, Dutch, Persians and Tamils, Arabs, French and English all rub their shoulders merrily with one another and emerge with a peculiar sense of oneness. So here he is saying, author is saying that Africans, Chinese, Biharis and Dutch, Persians and Arabs, Tamils, French and English all live together in oneness, a sense of oneness, in a unity. A Tamil, for instance, he is giving one example here. A Tamil, for instance, bears a deceptively South Indian face and a name to go with it to boot. So here the poet author is saying that he, a Tamilian, for example, a Tamilian has got peculiar face of Indian Tamilians face only, and they, he got similar name only, Radha Krishna Govindan is indeed from Madras. So Radha Krishna Govindan is from Madras. I speak to him in Tamil. So he met a person from Tamil and Madras. He spoke to, the author spoke to him. I speak to him in Tamil. So author spoke to him in Tamil, as the author himself knew Tamil. He surprises me by responding in a frightfully mangled English. So he uses a mangled English, means mishandled English, not proper English, with a heavy French accent. So this English used by the Radha Krishna Govindan is a mixture of English, French and maybe Tamil also. Mr. Govindan has no knowledge of Tamil, and his tongue has ceased curling to produce Tamil sounds centuries ago. So that means Mr. Govindan is living here in Mauritius since centuries. That means that his father, grandfather, maybe long back they have come to Mauritius and they have become the citizens of permanent citizens of Mauritius. So as he is not from Tamil, he is not staying in Tamil, therefore he doesn't know Tamil and his tongue doesn't twist like Tamil. Fifth para. Like others of his fellow men, his ancestors were brought to the islands as slaves or later as indentured laborers to work in sugarcane fields and factories, to do cut timber in the jungle and haul it to the boats. Their roots in their original homelands withered and disappeared with the passage of time. All of them together happily came to share in the trumps and defeats of whoever happened to be their masters among the buccaneer trinity of those days. The Dutch, the French, and the English, who constantly wage battle for the possession of the island, for its spices and sugar, for just for the strategic position on the maritime route to the east, conveniently placed as it was for piratical purposes. So what happened in Mauritius, the author is saying about the ancestor entry of some of the races into Mauritius. He says some of fellow men have come, the ancestors of the present citizens, residents of Mauritius, have come to Mauritius long ago. And the Mauritius, the ancestors were brought to Mauritius as slaves to some of the big, like Dutch, French and English people. They were brought here and as the indentured labor, as slaves and indentured labor to work in sugarcane fields. So maximum people work in the sugarcane fields, and to cut the timber in the jungle, and to haul it to the boat, so carry it to the boat. So that is why so many people were brought to Mauritius and were made as slaves and indentured labor to work in Mauritius, and from centuries they are living in that place only. So the roots of the original people who have brought there almost withered. Their origin itself is forgotten in the mainland from where they were brought to Mauritius. So the author also says about the fight of Dutch, French and English who wanted to make a strong stand in strong place in Mauritius by fight for the spices and sugar, and it is just strategic, just for strategic position. Sixth para speaks of, however, the battle of 1810 ended all that in favor of the English. So there was fight between French and English. The French surrendered and handed over the island after extracting a favor from the conquerors that the French influence on the island be left intact. The English kept their word to the last day of their rule, which ended in 1968. And so we'll still have very musical and unpronounceable names like Trucks, Beaches, View Basin, Quarter Boats, and Carpike, Rosebelle, and so on. So how the English became powerful in Mauritius, by there was a battle between English and French in 1810. And due to in that battle, French have lost, but French before surrendering to English have requested the English that their language should be, their influence of English should be left intact. The influence of French should be left intact. Therefore, till today, till 1968, English were ruling Mauritius, and after that the names still in the Mauritius, the names are very strange and musical, like Trucks, Beaches, View Basin, Quarter Boats, and Curepipe, Rosebelle, and so on. So due to that, the fight between French and English and the request of French to the English, and still till 1968 English have ruled Mauritius. Due to that, some of the names are very strange in Mauritius. Coming to para number 7, the people are extremely relaxed and warm towards strangers. In the streets, in the bazaar, in restaurants, It is common to be greeted and smiled at as if you were a long lost friend. So here the author says the people here are very friendly. It is common to be greeted and smiled. All people greet each other and smile to each other. Coming from Bombay, our author is from Bombay. Basically, he stays in Bombay. With my precast grim expression of a city dweller, usually Bombay, Mumbaians are a very friendly nature. So he says, even though I am of so friendly nature, I felt myself very strange here. As an expression of a city dweller, I react awkwardly at one first to such spontaneity and feel ashamed that I am not even able to produce matching smile. So he says that the people in Mauritius are so friendly. Even though author himself is from Mumbai, the Mumbaians are very known for their friendly nature. He felt ashamed of his smiles cannot be matched to their smiles and their friendly nature. Para number 8. The same atmosphere of friendliness prevails even in Port Louis. Port Louis is the capital of Mauritius. So Port Louis, the seat of government. So seat of government means the main administrative center is in Port Louis. The cabinet ministers and others in high position do not act as if they were born to the grace. So what the author is saying, though the ministers are in high positions, they don't pretend, they don't behave as if they are born in a high level or they are living in a grace. They are just like ordinary people. One bumps into an airport lounge or in a hotel lobby. So they behave very ordinarily as common people. And wherever they want to go, they visit and they stay in ordinary hotels and lounge. They are unassumingly accessible. Unassumingly accessible means here in India we cannot access the politicians. But in Mauritius, if you want to meet politicians, they're very you can access them very easily. Accessible, communicative, they speak very friendly and communicative. And above all, go about without a protective shield of hangers on the security men to repel casual approaches. So they don't have any security guards to protect them. They usually go as if they are common people and they don't need any kind of protection from security guards. I'm shown a modest looking flat in a busy street lined with shops and crawling traffic. So he, author, stays in a modest looking flat. So he goes there. It is the residence of a Prime Minister of Mauritius. He sees it's a very modest, very normal, common resident in that Mauritius. It is the resident of a Prime Minister of Mauritius. Port Louis brings to my mind Joseph Conrad and Wagham. This little port town seems as if it were built at the suggestion of these writers to suit their novels and short stories. Merchant ships, travelers, dinghies stand anchored in the harbor with the cobwebs and ropes and festoons in seamen's caps, lounge on oil drums and packing cases, or lean against bleak warehouse walls, smoking pipes. Sugarcane fields like a carpet. So here, whatever buildings types he has said in the above lines. And in the below lines, he has said that he can see the sugarcane fields that lie as if carpet of green colored carpet. Cover the island on all sides as far as I can see. So full island is covered with the sugarcane field. So you can also see the foot of the distant blue mountains that ring the island. So there are blue mountains. You can see blue mountains. A volcanic happening of geological ages. There are volcanic mountains as well. These mountains do not have the traditional mountainous pyramidical shape. So the mountains in Mauritius doesn't have pyramidical shapes, but their outlines are freakish and whimsical with unexpected sweeps and pendicular drops and pinpointed peaks precariously doing a balancing act with the boulders as big as a skyscrapers. So what the poet is saying, the mountains in this island are freakish, very strange. It has got steep pinpointed top and very steep type borders. So next para number 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I will deal with it next video. Till then, namaste.